we'll see the Western Kentucky Hilltoppers taking on the Jacksonville State Gamecocks. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Reese Davis, joined here in the booth, as always, by David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. Guys, let's tee this one up. And the Hilltoppers will put toe to leather and we'll get started. On the move from inside his five. He was looking for more running room, but none to be found as he stopped at the 23. The Gamecocks offense will get the first crack at it here. And here he comes. This offense is built completely around the talents of this running back, a rare commodity in today's game, and all eyes are on him.
And the defense knows it too. You know, every single snap, this defense is going to be keying on this running back, knowing that he is the key to the offense's success.
And that would be the definition of first down success, putting yourself in a good position. It's second and inches. I can do whatever I want next. I can take a shot down the field. I can run the football and get a new set of downs. Like, nice first down execution.
The give to the left. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three.
It's hard to run on a defense that comes off the ball like that and runs to the football like that. Good luck. No holes anywhere.
Ball sitting right at the 30. It'll be third and short. Trying to pick it up on the ground. And this defense has its work cut out to get this dude on the ground. He was shedding serious tackles on his way to picking up the first.
And I think on that last run play on third down here early in the game, they're making a statement that we believe we're the more physical team and we're going to run the football even if you know it's coming at you. Nice job. They've got the ball at midfield. I expect to see more run plays coming up.
Toss sweep to the right. They bring him down and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Well, the offense goes toss play, but guys, they do it running into the boundary where there's just not a lot of space and room to work for the running back. He had nowhere to go, and he got tackled for a loss.
Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. Softened him up with a run, and now to throw. Caught over the middle. It's Stewart. Hard-hitting tackle.
This defense is going to have to be careful. Not only do they have to worry about this guy running the football, but they've got to keep their eye on him when he runs routes, too. He is a versatile back.
As they come to the line on third and short from the 43, I wonder if they already know they'll go for it if they don't make it here. They'll try to run for it. And he's tripped up, but not before picking up the first down.
It's a really good sign if you're on offense here. You're putting it on your offensive line on third down. Critical down and distance, opening drive of the game. Let those guys fire off, get a hat on a hat. You can run the ball, pick up the first. You're around midfield. And all things looking pretty good here early for this offense.
To the ground. He's got it again. Nice, solid form tackle from this sophomore.
And offenses want to continue to feature the run. They want balance. Even if it's not super successful, you can take it a little bit at a time just to keep that defense honest.
Didn't get much on first down. It's second and nine. They'll run it out of the shotgun. And he does a really nice job finding open space and making a good gain before the stop is made.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting what was blocked, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
They'll come to the line for the eighth snap on this opening drive, facing a third and short. Crosses the 30. He's got away. And it is a chunk play, a huge gain on that one before the defense brings it to an end.
What a great run there. On third and one situation, though, David, that has got to be demoralizing for a defense because they were packed up close to the line of scrimmage expecting run on that one.
They're playing aggressive, but great offenses have the ability in predictable situations like third and one to get first downs.
They'll throw it from the red zone. Hit hard as he released the ball on that first down pass, and it never had a chance.
Doesn't take this defense a lot of time to get to the quarterback, man. They've got speed all over the place. They hit him so quickly, and because of that, the ball falls incomplete.
Second and 10 here. They'll run it from the gun. And he runs through one tackle and picks up a few.
It's really frustrating when you get a guy in his spot. He's in the hole. He's there to do his job. And he can't get the guy on the ground. That's your job. Get him on the ground. You know, especially a guy that's not a huge back, you got to make that tackle. You can't make it easy on the offense where now they got a manageable situation.
Back to throw. It's Huff. He's got him still on his feet. He gets it oh so close to the first down marker, but I think he's going to be a touch short. They were really hopeful he could make a guy or two miss and pick up the first down, but he comes up a little short.
Yeah, and it's great defense. It's defense understanding where the sticks are, not missing tackles, getting the guy on the ground quickly. Really nice job by the defense understanding the situation.
It is good! And the first points of the day come on that field goal.
This is a team that really prides themselves on starting fast. We've seen that before, and here they are playing at home today. Nice job on the opening drive. Lots of poise, good emotion. They don't get the touchdown they would have liked, but they kick a nice field goal. They've got the lead. Head coach has to be happy with that.
So after the made field goal, they'll kick it away and rely on their defense. And he takes this from inside the five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. So the Western Kentucky Hilltoppers offense will go to work for the first time. As we take a look at our impact players for this game, David, what do you look for to make an impact from your leaders?
Your leaders not only have to lead the football team, but they got to step up and make plays on the field, keep everybody calm. These guys typically do a really good job of it.
Yeah, David, and they also generally set the tone for their respective football teams. Regardless of which side of the ball they play on, the teammates look towards them to step up in big games like this.
It'll be a first and 10 from the 29. He's gonna pass. He's got his man. Really good job to pick up a chunk of yardage and get it out to the 39-yard line.
This receiver is such a weapon, and he has so much speed, and he can generate explosive plays for your offense, not just running go routes and post routes, but how about throwing him the drag, letting him catch it, and use his speed to turn it upfield.
Here's a quick throw out to the left. Really nice job there by both guys, the throw and the catch, to work that defense and get the first down.
And that's just a great individual effort by the wide receiver. He catches this ball way short of the sticks, but because he's able to make the defender miss, now he's able to get the extra yards and turn that into an explosive play.
The Hilltoppers come to the line with a fresh set of downs. Caught in the backfield, it's Johnson. And oh, did they know that one was coming? They'll knock him down in the backfield.
Well, that receiver's looking at his teammates like, guys, what's up? You're not going to block for me on the screen? Seriously? I mean, I just lost yards on a screen play. How does that happen?
Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. Back to the air one more time. Using the quick game. They make the stop after the catch and still some work to do to pick up that first down.
My old coach said you'll never go broke taking a profit. Take what's there, take the positive yards, and never complain.
Ball at the 38. The defense will try to get a stop on third and short. Looking to throw for it. Shoots it to the left. Complete downfield. And he's knocked down immediately, but not before he moves the chains.
And I love the awareness by the wide receiver on that play, because I'm not sure that route was supposed to be that deep. You got to wonder if the receiver decided maybe to adjust the route a little bit to make sure that he got the first down.
Trying to find his man on first down. It's caught downfield. The tackle is made, but he's got it first and goal from the six.
And a really good job by the quarterback being very decisive. He saw his matchup, he went for it, he attacked it, got the positive gain. I would say he's going to find that guy a few more times today.
And the Hilltoppers trying to pay off the threat on first and goal. Looking to throw. Fires to the end zone. Almost intercepted. They took a shot on first down and just about turned the thing over.
And that's just a huge miss opportunity on offense. QB missed his guy wide open in the end zone. You might not get another clean look like that in the rest of this game.
Can the D deny them on second and goal? He'll run it to the middle, looking for the end zone. He bullies his way all the way down to the 5-yard line.
Unsuccessful second down, and now I'm immediately thinking, I got a little bit more than I want, so what are my pass plays? What am I going to get into here offensively to try to have success on third down?
Man, the last thing you want after controlling the ball, moving it down the field, is to have to settle for a field goal attempt. It's third and goal. Pressure coming. And that one sails through the back of the end zone.
Got to give the defense credit on that play, taking everything away, forcing the incompletion. Now it's decision time. Fourth and short, and you're in field goal range. What do you do here?
Now on fourth down, here comes the field goal team. And this one ought to be nice and easy, a 22-yard attempt. It's good. And that's going to give us a tie ball game. And we're all square as he's set to kick it away. From inside the 10, here he comes. Finds just enough space to cross the 25. Let's mark it at the 27-yard line. First play of this drive comes from the 27. Running back searching for a hole. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple.
Don't you love energetic defenses that fly around, that make things happen? The ones that get in the backfield, the running back tries to go somewhere. Where do you want him to go? There is nowhere to go. Nice job by the defense creating the tackle for a loss on first down.
And here comes the offense on second down. Entertaining first quarter, and we are all locked up after one as we take a quick look at some stats. They fought to a standstill in the first. Let's see who gets the edge early in the second. Looking downfield, it's Huff. Floating away. On the run, and he'll slide to avoid the hit. A nifty pickup there.
Well, great job there by the defense because they weren't able to get him sacked right away, but you saw the coverage in the back end. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football. Didn't get the sack, obviously. You don't get the negative play, but you also don't give up a big one. You're feeling pretty good about where you are right now in this drive.
Faced with a third and short from their own 32 to keep this drive alive. From the gun, wants to pass. Looking down the middle. Got his man. He's got first down yardage across the 50. They'll mark it at the 49.
There's a reason third down is called the money down. What a great find by the quarterback. Great job finding his receiver. At the end of the game, you look at third down percentages, it tells a huge story, and it goes a long way in deciding who wins a football game.
The Gamecocks have it with a first and 10. Use the play fake, now to throw. Just missed his man, gave him just a little too much.
I think when you go through these progressions as a quarterback, you want to find the right guy to throw to, obviously. I didn't think he was the right guy. I didn't think he was really that open. And listen, he sailed and he overthrew, but I might have surveyed the middle of the field a little bit better there.
Second down coming up. Trying play action. Grabbed in the backfield. It's Stewart. And that defense pushing him out of bounds after a short gain.
that was a really good job by the defense. Again, keeping everything in front of you in that situation. And now you're rewarded with the third and long. So on this down, we'll see if they bring some pressure or if they lay back and play something.
Third down conversions are a huge stat, and this one would be a doozy if they can pull it off. Looking to throw it again. Unloads to the wideout. Makes the grab. Really nice pickup on that one as they get it to the 36. It'll be first down.
It's really hard when you get in those predictable situations. Defenses are sitting on the sticks. Receivers have to understand where that first down marker is. Heads up play, nose for the first down marker. Get in there and get it.
On the ground, it's Stewart. Brought down at the 30-yard line. It's a gain of 6.
You want to talk about making it easy for an offensive coordinator. You pick up a bunch of yards on first down, make that second down really, really manageable. That's a great job by the offense.
6-yard pickup on first down leaves him with 2nd and 4. Hand off from the gun. Drives ahead for 3 to the 27-yard line.
And those physical runs take a toll. It might not be a big game now, but down the road, third, fourth quarter, late in the ball games, they tend to turn into bigger runs.
They've been really good moving the chains on third down. Now 1 yard away from another first down on this drive. Looking to move the chains, they throw it complete to the left. Just outside the red zone, if they pick up the first down, they'll spot it at the 22.
Wow, and what a great job by that quarterback finding his open receiver on third down. You know, guys, one of the most telling stats at the end of the game is third down conversion percentage. If you're a great third down team, it's invaluable to your offensive success, and that's why teams drill third down so much in practice.
Throws to the wideout, and it's incomplete. If you're going to take a hit like that, you might as well hang on to the ball. Here comes the offense on second down. After the incompletion, they go back up top. And that pass will be jarred loose on second down. That brings up third down.
And the big tight end, a lot of times that's a bigger strike zone, a bigger dude, and you could tell they put the hit on him, and that ball came out, and it came to the turf. Nice job playing physical by this defense.
This drive was clicking along, but after a couple of misfires, threatening to stall out on 3rd and 10. Now improvising. Nifty little scamper on this one. Enough for the first down, and he slides in safely.
And this is why defensive coordinators lose sleep at night, because guys like this have the football in their hand almost every single play. Third down, nothing open. He makes it happen himself. Now set up with a great scoring opportunity with 1st and goal.
To the air, it's Huff. Moves around to clear up the vision. He's got it down to the 1 yard line, right on the doorstep of Pater.
And I really like the decision by the quarterback there. And listen, it's early in the downs. Like, don't force it. Don't make a turnover. He tucks it, get what you can get, and then live to play the next down. I like that execution by the QB.
Looking for just 1 more yard. It's 2nd and goal. Trying to barge their way in. Into the end zone he goes. Touchdown, Jacksonville State. They just took the air out of that thing. That might be an understatement. They took the ball away and just wore down, just grinded away at that defense.
And took a lot of time off the clock in the process as well. I'm impressed with the physicality up front of this offense, because that's where it all starts. If you're going to march the ball down the field like they just did, got to be dominating in the trenches, and they are doing that in this game right now.
Getting set for the point after. And the extra point is true, and they're on top by 7. That is what they mean when they say ball control, a 14-play touchdown drive. And they capped it off with a 1-yard punt. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. Here he comes from inside his own 5. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. Here comes the Western Kentucky offense back onto the field. Always good to get points on a drive, David, but chip shot field goals can leave you a little empty.
And I think it's great to get points, but the great teams get touchdowns in the red area. You got to get out there this time and execute a little better on this drive.
You're absolutely right, David. And generally, the best red zone offenses are the ones that run the ball the best. So let's see if they can be a little bit more physical on this drive.
He had the perfect play to open the drive, and now they'll snap it again from the 38. They'll throw it on first down. Good timing on the quick out.
And these quarterbacks have to really trust their wide receivers that they're going to be disciplined and run to the right route when they're throwing that ball to the outside like that, because those corners are sitting there on the inside, and the worst thing that could happen is to miss inside and that cornerback get going the other direction.
Let's see what they've got on second down. The give to the right. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three. It's amazing how a play by a defensive end in the backfield can really swing the momentum not only of a series but of a game sometimes.
All you're trying to do is create negative plays, to get them behind the sticks a little bit, to get those sacks, to get those tackles for losses. You see so much stunting in college football up front with the defensive line because you know once you get one of those plays, you got the offense right where you want.
He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down. Now, we'll hang on here. The coach has called a timeout. He wants the officials to take another look. Thinks he's got a good shot at getting this one overturned. So he took a chance by using a timeout on the challenge, and it comes back to bite him. We'll see if he needs that timeout later. Right down the middle. A strike downfield. And he gets it down to the 4-yard line before he's finally stopped. A terrific run after the catch.
Man, I'm the quarterback, and I drop back in four verts. What can I see on my safety? Is it single high? If it's single high, I know exactly where I'm going with the football. Look the safety off, zip it in there. Either way, I know I got four guys streaking right down the field.
The Hilltoppers have it in scoring position on first and goal. They'll try to get it in with the run. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, WKU. Man, did he show some hops for that one.
Some serious vertical right there. I tell you what, everybody in front of you, hey, I'll go by air if I need to. Good job getting in the air, getting the touchdown.
He'll try to tack on one more. And it's perfect. So that scoring drive took only six plays. And they finished it off with the score from the four. All tied up and just about set to kick it away. He'll start the return inside his five. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. Guys, we'll see what Jacksonville State can get going on O. How about the way they attacked the last time they had the ball, mixing run and pass and winding up in the end zone, Jesse?
That's why recruiting.
And the pressure gets there, and down he goes at the 18.
Well, the problem with the play-action game is that it forces the QB to hold on to the ball just a little bit longer to allow some of these plays to develop. And, of course, that gives this defense longer to get after him.
We'll see if they can get a little better protection after the sack. It's second and 12. To throw, it's Hop. He looks that one in nicely. And the defense settled in to stop that one for a short gain.
Yeah, great job creating space. That's what you're supposed to do. When you get man coverage, you got to find a way to get a step, make it easy for your quarterback to read that leverage. And when he drags across the field, he can see he had him. He completes it for the first down.
Not exactly the ideal situation for this offense. Third and long, backed up inside their 20. from the shotgun, the handoff to the back. They stop him after a short game, probably just wanted to mitigate the losses with fourth down coming. Timeout called here by the defense. It's the first one they've used this half. And the Gamecocks will punt it away on fourth down. This will be their first punt of the afternoon. Oh, he gave him a dead leg. Coverage team able to put a stop to that return at the 42-yard line. The Hilltopper offense comes onto the field again. Fires to the wideout. All kinds of room to throw that one in there. And he was off to the races, finally tripped up at the 36.
Wow, the quarterback knew he had to get that one to his receiver quickly on the in route. Did you see the velocity on that throw?
Now from the 36-yard line, it's first and 10. Looking to move it through the air. Quickly complete. They make the stop right there. Good pickup. It's still short of the first down.
And I love when my quarterback sees zone and knows exactly where to go with the football. Sees the wide receiver running the drag route, knows when to throw it, pulls the trigger for the easy completion.
Second and short now after that completion. He's looking to throw. Grabbed in the middle. It's Young. They didn't get a ton of yardage there, but they're really effective at using the back out of the backfield, and they do it to get the first down here. And the Hilltoppers come to the line with a new set of downs. Looking to go up top on first down. And this will be incomplete. A big hit there forces second down. Couldn't make the connection last time. Let's see if they throw it again. Lost a fire on second down. And he was hit just as he released it, and it falls to the turf.
It's hard throwing in the pocket, man. You got bodies and 300-pound dudes falling all over the place. They're trying to hit you. That time, the pressure got to him, and it forced the incompletion.
Quite a bit of work to do on third down from the 23, and this D would love to force a field goal try. From the gun, wants to pass. Got his man on the right. Tight windows, no problem to grab the tackle, and it's first down in the red zone at the 10. The Hilltoppers have pushed it inside the 20. Comes out throwing on first down. Good job to avoid the negative play and just get rid of that thing. Second down coming up on this red zone opportunity. He's looking to throw. He makes a grab. He gets it in. Touchdown, Toppers. So much about the passing game is about timing, execution, communication, and these two, that's a virtual textbook there.
And no doubt about it, and the receiver making plays for his quarterback, being dependable, running the route to the right depth consistently, does a great job running his route, great result because of it.
They'll try to tack one more on their score. And the extra point is true, and they're on top by 7. That drive covered 57 yards for the touchdown. And they finish it off by connecting from 10 yards out. They got the late touchdown on the board, now about to kick it away and hoping the defense can keep them from answering. On the run from inside his own 5. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. Jacksonville State has it back, and the Gamecocks will go to work. It's complete to the left. And chunk plays are the name of the game, and they get one here before the defense finally makes the stop. That's a way to give yourself some breathing room. Now the second play of the drive from the 36. He uncorks one deep. And this is dropped. Incomplete pass. He had a huge gain in his fingers and he couldn't hold on.
Hey, listen, the quarterback didn't get the completion on that throw, but that doesn't mean you can't try again. Trust in your playmakers outside to push the field and stretch it vertically and make a play for you. It won't surprise me to see this QB take more shots as this game goes on.
Looking to throw, it's Huff. Finds his tight end. They'll use a timeout right before halftime. Maybe time for one or two more plays. Just a few seconds remaining here as they try to put something up before halftime. On third down, he drops to throw. Just threw that one away to avoid disaster.
Well, the quarterback and his intended target just simply didn't have the timing there. The ball falls incomplete on third, now setting up fourth down.
Just enough time to get off one final play of the half. On fourth down, looking to pass. They're trying to get to it. Pass is incomplete, and that's going to do it for the first half. We've played two quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Guys, who's had a better seat there in Jacksonville for an entertaining first half than you? And I get it. A lot of coaches will say the difference between winning and losing comes down to stopping big plays and getting big plays. But if you ask me, it's more about how good you are on third down and how efficient you are in keeping drives alive. Those two stats can help you break the will of even the best defenses and help you come out on top. And with that, let's head back to the guys at JSU Stadium.
Just about set for the second half kickoff. He'll bring it back from inside his five. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. Here comes the Western Kentucky offense back onto the field. He unleashes a long one. And that'll be incomplete. Man, that would have been a big hitter on first down, but second down's coming up.
Really good job by the defense taking away the deep ball. Remember, you can roll those corners up, or you can roll those corners back. You want to take away the deep ball, keep them back deep. You want to take away the shallow stuff, bring them up tight on the line of scrimmage.
They'll line up for a second down play. He's looking to throw. Got it set up on the outside. Finally run out of bounds, but he has this offense rolling with a first down.
Well, they pick up the first down there on the screen. I love the offensive line there, allowing the pass rush to get way up the field. They completely baited their guys, made them think that they got beaten, that they were going to get the sack, and then they sneak the running back screen right in behind them and pick up the first.
They'll throw it on first down. It's complete to the right. Stopped after making the catch.
It's hard to have success on wide receiver screens when you're facing press man coverage because your blockers out front oftentimes can't pick them up, and that receiver gets gobbled up as soon as he catches the pass. You saw it on that last play.
This offense has a second down play. From the shotgun, the inside give. And he'll have enough for the first down at the 42.
Well, the offense knew what they needed to get that first down, so they dial up the running play, and they get just enough to keep the drive alive.
And the Hilltoppers have their offense in high gear. Wants to throw on first down. Got it behind the line. It's Young. And that's a very productive first down play in bringing up second and three.
Guys out of the backfield now, it's not just run the ball downhill anymore. You got to be versatile. I got to be able to trust you in the pass game, and I got to be able to throw you the football, and you can do that right there. I know you're going to catch it, and I can depend on you.
Set up for second and short after that completion. He's looking to throw. Caught in the backfield, it's Young. And it is well blocked as they pick up enough for a first down.
Well, you've seen the last two plays now. This guy's versatility, and you've seen why he might be playing on Sundays in the not-too-distant future. This guy can catch the ball. He's a big part of their passing game, and he's a weapon and a guy that this defense has got to be ready for.
The Hilltoppers getting set on first and 10. The receiver on the jet sweep. And he finds some solid space, makes a nice gain before the defense is able to stop him. Now on second down. Hands it off. And the defense holds firm. No pickup at all on that play.
Well, you love to see that from the defense, right? It's like bend, don't break. They've given up a bunch of plays on this drive, but now that they're getting damn close to field goal range, you're seeing them start to stiffen up.
Yeah, and plays don't matter anymore. Yards don't matter. All that matters with these defenses nowadays is points and limiting them.
Quick pass to the left, trying to get it to the marker. Just couldn't find any room, and he wound up throwing it in reverse. They lost yardage.
Well, give the defense credit on that one, because they knew coming into this one that they were going to try to get this receiver the ball in a variety of ways. They were ready for the screen there, and they create a negative play.
Now on fourth down, they'll settle for a field goal try. He's already made one field goal, but this one is going to need a big leg. A 50-yard attempt coming. Right down the boulevard, it's good. And that lead grows even bigger.
Well, that kid just showed off his hammer for a leg, 50 plus, and he did it with ease.
After putting three on the board, the kickoff unit ready to go. On the move from inside is five. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. Guys, we'll see what Jacksonville State can get going on O. On the run, it's Stewart. The deficit here is just 10 points, David, so a chance to answer here.
Plenty of time left in this football game. No need to panic. This offense just has to put a couple drives together. And listen, the defense will get this back and get some stops, Palmer, and get you the football back.
And I think here too, David, you have an opportunity to keep the pressure on the opponent. Yeah, they just went down and scored, but you score here. And
that defense gets to him, and down he goes at the 9.
The defense just simply not fooled by the play action. Oftentimes, as an offense, you're hoping the run fake's going to slow down those pass rushers, but man, oh man, they had their ears pinned back.
And they're trying to dig out of the hole on second and long from the 9. They'll run play action. Finds a tight end. They make the stop, but not before he takes a chunk out of what they need to move the sticks.
And that's why play action is going to be big in this game. You saw how it just frees the second level of that defense just for a second and allowed the tight end to work himself vertically down the field. But how about this guy after the catch, right? So hard to bring down. What a weapon.
On third and long, doesn't need to take the check down. It's complete. A huge pickup. He's running free down the middle. Touchdown, Gamecocks. And once he found daylight, it was Katie bar the door, baby. How about that quarterback taking the shot downfield and delivering to the wide open receiver?
I love this quarterback, Reese, because he's aggressive. He wants to take shots. He's looking for every opportunity to show off that cannon and that arm talent. He showed it to all of us right there.
On On to attempt the try. And it's up and good as they draw just a touch closer. Quick strike offense on that three-play scoring drive. And they put points up in electrifying fashion with an 82-yard toss for six. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. And he takes this from inside the five. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. The Hilltopper offense comes onto the field again. He wastes no time and comes out throwing. Grabbed behind the line, it's Johnson. And they do a really good job, not as easy as it looks, to get those blocks. And he picks up the first down.
Zone coverage means everybody's looking at the quarterback. So now, when I'm a wide receiver, I got to make sure I know I fit in the hole between these zones. I know where they're dropping to, and I know where I need to get to. Great job by the wide receiver finding that hole and the quarterback throwing a strike.
A most efficient pickup of six on first down. It's second and four.
It's a nice game, but the big theme here is they just haven't been able to get the run game going on offense. They've been very one-dimensional. They're just not being physical enough at the point of attack.
Got six on first down. Now a lot of options on second and four. Now the play fake. It's complete on the right side. And the defense makes the immediate tackle, but he has enough for the first down.
And as a quarterback, when you're facing man coverage, you've got to find your best one-on-one matchup. That receiver did a tremendous job. Quickness, changing direction, out of his break, able to create separation. There was no question the quarterback was going to target that receiver on that play.
Caught behind the line. It's Young. And just a short, safe pass play. They pick up a few. They were able to make the completion, but he had to pick his way for just a little bit. Needed a little more help to spring him for some yardage.
Yeah, if you're going to have success when you throw it outside like that, you're going to need some more blocking and better blocking downfield. Give the defense credit, though. They were able to rally and made a tackle.
Wide out in motion. He wants to throw here on second down. Caught in the backfield. It's Johnson. And good coverage by the defense, just a short game.
I love offenses and quarterbacks that are willing to take the easy stuff. Take those easy throws that are guaranteed to get positive yards. Yeah, I'm going to take big shots down the field too. But don't forget, it's easier to pick up second and five, third and five, than it is when we start getting those long yardage situations.
On third and long, try to convert through the air. Trying to pick up the first out of the backfield. And it's pretty obvious there was a big hole in that screen and the defense ran right through it. And the Hilltoppers will send out the punt unit. He ought to be able to use his first punt to pin him deep. And the return man will have no chance as the ball sails out of bounds. Jacksonville State has it back and the Gamecocks will go to work. They put it in the end zone the last time they had it, and now an opportunity to really take control of this game.
You can feel the momentum shifting. If they were able to take the football here, drive it down the field, score again, David, they would have all of that momentum on their side.
And there's nothing about momentum that you can quantify. Like, I don't understand it, but once it gets going in one direction, a lot of times it's so hard to swing it back the other direction. The momentum is real, and they got it.
The toss sweep to the right. Not a lot of daylight. He gets one to the 32. Didn't get much on first down. It's second and nine. Back to pass. It's Hop. Quick strike complete. He's close to the first down, but they're going to mark him just a little short.
Yeah, you throw a little hitch route. Nice job getting the ball out of his hands quickly. Wide receiver, quarterback. Nice job being on the same page. Nice completion, nice catch.
Big catches, big plays, tons of yards through three quarters for these two guys. One more period to go to see who can make the winning plays and come home with the victory. They've got it at the 41, third and short, trying to keep the chains moving. On the option. That just never had a chance as they controlled the middle of the field and stopped him in the backfield on third down.
It's third down, it's money down, and you could just tell something wasn't right from the get-go with that play. And, you know, it strung along and the option just didn't work, and the defense was very successful. Fourth down coming for this offense.
Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. Bringing it back, it's Hutchinson. They'll put that return to a stop at the 33, but the offense set up in pretty good field position. Okay, so here comes the offense returning to the field. Going up top on first down. Throws for the tight end. How about that play to get a hand in there and force the incompletion?
Well, they've done a lot of really nice things on the road in this game so far, and that's why they have the lead. But after that incompletion now, you can sense the momentum now switching back to the home team late in this game.
After the quarterback and receiver couldn't connect, it's second and 10. The RPO, fire complete to the left.
It's so nice as a quarterback when you've got a guy like that working for you in the slot. He has such a good feel to find the open spaces in the defense. Just makes life so much easier for his quarterback.
Now staring at a third and short from the 40. They'll try to bully their way for the first. They thought they could just run it on third and short, but this defense was there to make the stop.
How about the defender being a heat-seeking missile? He was on radar lock. He found the football and flew down with some bad intentions.
The Hilltoppers will bring the punt team onto the field. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. He'll call for the fair catch here. Guys, we'll see what Jacksonville State can get going on O. They hope to be able to cash in on this drive, David, after having to punt it last time.
Yeah, and I think this offense needs to start it with the first play. You need to be successful and productive on that first play, and it gets you in less predictable situations.
No doubt, too. Don't you just feel like there's a little bit more sense of urgency on this drive? It just feels like they've got to be able to put some points up on the board here.
And now on second down for this offense. Here's the handoff. Still running at the 40. And the defense finally makes the stop after the sweet run and good gain.
On offense, you have got to love the way your offensive line is playing in this game. They're getting tremendous movement up front. They're climbing in the second level and really giving these backs and ball carriers a lot of room to run all game long.
Dropping back, it's Huff. He finds his man.
Yeah, and that was tough on the DB, right? He's trying to cover the receiver on a drag route, running back over the middle of the field. You're trying to avoid all the linebackers, all the congestion. He just couldn't stay with them long enough, and as a result, fresh set of downs for the offense.
Offense gets set for second down. Motion, trying to get the defense to show his hand. Gonna let it fly, and it slips through his fingers, incomplete. That would have been a huge gain if he could have held on.
Yeah, he had an opportunity to make such a big play. Listen, he wasn't wide open with nobody around him, but you gotta make that play. You got a little bit of space. You gotta haul that in, make your quarterback look good, and make a big play for this offense.
He just flat dropped it. He had the ball and didn't look it all the way in, and it'll be fourth down.
You know, timing is so important in the RPO game, especially on third down. Quarterback and receiver just didn't have it there, and now it's fourth down.
It's a one-score game late, and they've got to go for it on fourth down. They'll run the option. Short of the marker, and a stop for this defense, and they get the ball back. Three tight ends in the formation on first and 10. Wide receiver shows motion. Leaves it with the back. They pick up half of it. It'll be second and five.
And if you'd have told this defense that they stuffed this great running back today, they'd have taken it. They'd have been happy. But the offense has still put up production, and they're still in the lead, trying to find a way to finish this one off.
Halfway there on first down, it's second and five. Gonna run it. It's Young. Really nice stop there from this senior leader. Might be decision time if the defense can get a stop on third down from the 45. They try to pop a run on the draw. Now with a great opportunity as they pick up the first down, they've got it at the 40.
It's a point in the game, I think, as a coaching staff, where you really challenge your offensive line to go win the football game, right? We've got a lead late. We're going to run the football. And the defense and everybody in the stadium knows that's what's going to happen. Can we run the ball down their throats and impose our will? That's what this offense right now is trying to do.
We'll give him a couple on that one. Second and eight coming up.
And how about this offense, man? Being able to succeed, still winning without their bell cow, without their star being their star. This offense has not had a great game on the ground, but they're still in the lead.
Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need eight on second down. On the move. Able to squeeze out a couple on the play. It's down at the 35.
Well, you got to give this offense a ton of credit because normally they've got the lead because of this running back. Today, it's actually despite him. They really haven't gotten the production out of him that they expect week in, week out. You got to give the defense credit for that. But other guys on offense have been able to step up enough to make the plays necessary to give them the lead.
He's got his man, makes the grab. And they gave him no chance to get loose, and they force a fourth down.
And after that completion, it's decision time now for the head coach. Do you kick a field goal, add to your lead, make it more difficult on the opposing offense, or do you trust your quarterback to make one more big completion here and ice the game?
So on fourth down, here comes the field goal kicker in a huge spot. Knocked it right through, showing that big range from 48 yards out. After that last field goal drive, they're set to kick it away. From inside his own 10, he'll try to help out their field position. He was looking for more running room, but none to be found as he stopped at the 23. Wasting no time throwing on this drive. Just a short pass to the tight end. Good pickup on that play. It'll bring up second and four. Really good concept there to get things going and use the tight end early.
Yeah, I mean, just such a great job on first down, setting up an easier second down. Understanding I don't always have to push the ball down the field, but see the tight end, make the throw. No, it's not a big gain, but makes life really easy on me on second down.
Fires to the big fella. They're able to get him stopped just shy of the first down marker.
I don't know who on defense is going to cover this guy. Honestly, he could be a problem for this defense over the middle of the field in the passing game.
Faced with a third and short from their own 32 to keep this drive alive. They'll try to get the first through the air. He's going to take off. The Gamecocks brought to the ground, but not before picking up the first.
Man, these are killers, right? Late in the game, in the fourth quarter, you're getting to the quarterback, but he does such a great job scrambling around. When you do this, you get extra first downs. You start to wear those defensive linemen out. So late in the game, this could pay off. Great job getting the first down.
And the Gamecocks have it with a first and 10. To the air, it's Huff. throws to the tight end. Oh, picked off. And they'll drag him down after a good return on the interception. That's why you love veterans in this defense. They stay locked in on their rules, and he made the pick. Here comes the Western Kentucky offense back onto the field. So that defense keeps the lead right where it is and a chance to build on it, David.
Yeah, the defense did a great job. Now, the offense, you know what you're going to get from this defense. They have to be aggressive. They're trying to get the football back later in the game, Jesse.
Because they're going to be so aggressive too, David, you know on offense now you have a chance to break one maybe in the run game or finding a one-on-one matchup in the passing game to really pad the lead.
The give as they work on that clock. And they'll stop him after a minimal pickup. Defense uses a timeout quickly, trying to get that ball back and preserve time for their offense. They're close enough for a makeable field goal from the 26, but they'd love to convert this third and long. Hand off from the shotgun. And he's knocked down, but not before moving the chains. Timeout called there by the defense, desperate to get the ball back and save as much time as possible. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. Looks like the offense will just take a knee.